My wife and I have been thinking long and hard about how we wanted to announce this special news, and we thought about it long and hard, and we thought there's no better place to announce it than the first place that we met, and that is here in the WWE in front of all of you. So, without further ado, my wife Maryse and I are, go ahead, babe.
We're having a baby.
And to honor this little miracle, I've prepared a speech. Fatherhood is a privilege that belongs to great men that maybe you don't comprehend this, but you just interrupted a deeply personal moment between my wife and I. Understand that this is my show, and I announce you when I'm ready.
No. Hey, listen, bro. I told him to hit my music. A, I'm supposed to be out at B. I wanted to come out and celebrate. That was great news. I wanted to celebrate with you and your wife, Maryse. Hey, don't.
Don't you dare. How you doing, my wife?
All right, touche. Might have been taken out of context, but nonetheless, you know, sometimes I tend not to think before I speak.
And that's the trouble with you, isn't it? You don't think. When you came from NXT to WWE Monday Night Raw, you and Cass were the next big thing. You would sell out merchandise, pay-per-views with John Cena. Everyone loved Enzo and Cass, but look at you now. Time progresses, and you don't know when to shut your mouth. You don't listen. You think you know everything better than everybody else. That's why you're kicked out of WWE tour buses, and that is why you are kicked out of the WWE locker room. You think you chose to bring your personality to the cruiserweight division? There was nowhere else for you to go, because no one on the WWE Monday Night roster can stand you. I see so much freaking talent in you, but you make mistake after mistake after mistake, and I am sick of watching it. And you don't have a 7 foot tall meal ticket anymore. Yeah, all you got now is nothing more that people can look at you and look at that you're nothing more than a con artist with a couple of catchphrases.
As you alluded to, Mikey, me and you have been in similar situations, but you and I have got nothing in common. You made enemies in that locker room because you copied everybody. You copied the likes of Chris Jericho and Ric Flair. Well, maybe this gets annoying, all right? But I'll tell you one thing about this. This and I, we are original. And you, you ain't, okay? You're a carbon copy of other people. All right, pal? I am going on to No Mercy to become the Cruiserweight Champion after I beat Neville. And you, I got no problem coming back on Raw and beating you, because you ain't nothing but a paper champion.
You think you're championship material? Hanzo, you think you're championship material? If you were championship material, your best friend wouldn't have abandoned you.
Hey, listen, I might not got a lot of friends, all right? But the only two things I need, I got to fight you right here, right now.
You have no idea what you're getting into. Understand that I'm gonna show you how to walk, talk, and look, and act like a champion. And I'll tell you what, I'm gonna dedicate my victory to my unborn child.
I'll apologize to that baby when it's born, okay? But Daniel Bryan was right. There's only one word to describe you, and I'm gonna spell it out for you. F-A-W-F-T.